Hi, everybody. Greg Wilkins, back here with you with another edition of the Daily Pause, a devotional of positivity and encouragement for Thursday, January 26th, 2023. I pray that you not only have a very blessed day today, but that today's devotional will serve as an encouragement, a motivation, and an inspiration for you, and put a smile on your face as well. If you enjoy the Daily Pause devotional, please do me a favor and hit that like button down below. And to catch more episodes of The Daily Pause, check out my YouTube channel, Greg Wilkins, my Facebook page, The Daily Pause, and on Twitter, you can catch more episodes at GregWilkins78. And feel free to share this devotional that you're watching right now with anyone you feel may be blessed or encouraged by it. And also encourage them to like, follow, and subscribe to The Daily Pause devotional. Once again, I thank you for watching, and I pray that every devotional you watch from the Daily Pause continues to help you strive to be the best that you can be on any given day. And always remember that God loves you, God cares for you, and God will always be there for you. We are on the second installment of our 10-week series called A Songwriter's Portrait. And this week we feature a composer-songwriting collaborative duo. They are very prolific with each other. They do a lot of things together. And between the two of them, I think they have at least 28, 29 Grammys and some Oscar awards, some Oscars in there as well. So today we are talking about David Foster and Carol Bayer Sager. They have done many works together, but in this one particular song that they did, it was in around, I think, 1998, and the animated movie Quest for Camelot came out. It had Bronson Pinchot, Jane Seymour, who's the James Bond? I keep forgetting. Pierce Bronson, that's it. And it's an animated feature, and it featured their voices, and it's about a young King Arthur who was just coming up, and it was building his castle Camelot, and an evil guy came along and stole his sword, and it was up to a little girl to take the dangerous quest to go find Excalibur. And I never seen it. It sounds like it's a pretty interesting little movie, but it's a musical animated thing. And David Foster and Carol Bayer Sager were charged in writing songs for it, all original music. And one of the songs they wrote for it was a little inspirational thing that that the characters would stay safe and inspired throughout their journey through life. And when asked about this song, David Foster said, it's hard for me to pick a favorite song, but if I had to, it'd have to be this one. He said, because quite honestly, it's the closest thing I ever come to writing anything in a classical music style, because he's used to more R&B and pop and pop influence and stuff like that. If anybody doesn't know, if you around Christmas time, if you hear that instrumental version of The Carol of the Bells by David Foster, that should bring you kind of what his style is, and that kind of pop, kind of energetic style that he writes in. So writing in classical style was new to him, but he said this was a moment for him. And when he came together and Carol, he said, when Carol wrote the lyrics to this song, it just made a moment. I don't have many words to say. It's just a moment. This was a moment for her. And when Carol was asked about it, she said, this song means a lot to me because it pretty much exemplifies what everybody's looking for in life. Safety and inspiration. We all look to be inspired by someone or something in life, and we all desire a place of safety when we're in trouble, when we don't know what's going on. We want to be able to have that safe place in which we can go. It's a beautiful, beautiful song. And the name of the song is The Prayer. And the two artists they got to charge are two of David Foster's favorite artists of all time, Celine Dion and Italian tenor AndreaBocelli. And they did this song in both Italian and in English for this movie, Quest for Camelot. And then they did it separately, a solo for in English and Italian on their own albums. But then they did a duet of this song on their respective albums in 1998 and 1999. I think Celine Dion's is called These Are Special Times. And I don't know the Italian name for AndreaBocelli's album, but they've done they both featured a duet on both of those albums, and they both done appearances together singing this song. It's a beautiful song. It's been covered by many, many artists, and it's touched and it's inspired a lot of people. When in an interview, I think it was with, I forget who it was, what I forgot where I saw it, but the David Foster interview, in which I based a lot of this stuff on, said that it touches him to know that random people come up to him and say, I love that song. I love the prayer. It really inspires me to keep on searching for hope and peace in myself and be inspired to give that hope and peace to other people and to look for that safe place. And there's always hope that there's safety in this world. There's peace in this world. There's grace in this world. It's a beautiful, beautiful song. And it also reminds me of growing up in church. And our church services, near the end, we would take up our offering towards the end, and there'll be announcements and whatnot, but people will usually just leave their offering and tip on out the door. And I can hear we're playing instruments, the choir singing a song, and the ushers are collecting the offering and what, or people are walking down and they're doing all that stuff, all that kind of stuff. And I can hear the pastor, it was either Bishop Jackson or it was Apostle Rooker, jump on the microphone. Hey, don't leave until you get the benediction. Don't leave until you get the benediction. Please don't leave. Please don't leave. I know you might have somewhere you got to go, but please don't leave until you get the benediction. Please don't leave until there's a covering over you. And that's the safety that we all need to get through our week, our day, our month, our year, that benediction. That may the Lord bless you and keep you. May his Lord, may he rest upon you. May he always be with you and always cover you and protect you. One of my favorite ones that I always remember is, may the grace of God and his sweet communion of the Holy Spirit rest, rule, and abide and put upon you now, henceforth, and forever. In Jesus' name, amen. That prayer of safety, that prayer of keeping ourselves inspired and knowing that God will cover us, God will protect us, God will keep us, God will be there with us, is so essential. And that's why so many people were drawn to this song, a song from an animated movie that became so much bigger. And ironically enough, while this song was huge internationally, it got off to a very slow start in the United States. It didn't even make the top 100 in the pop or in the classical charts at all. It took years for it to get there, but it finally got there and it spread like wildfire, because you can't hold back something that encouraging. You can't hold back something that inspirational. You can't hold back something that touches so many people, because it's all something that we all want to be. We want to be inspired. We want to be encouraged, and we want to have that place of safety when we don't know where we go, when we falter, when we slip up, when we make mistakes. We want to have that place in which we can go. And that place we can go is Jesus Christ. So wait, let this be our prayer each and every day, that he guide us, lead us to a place, and he guide us in his grace. Be in a place so we are safe. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into it and are safe. The Lord is our refuge and strength, a very present help in time of trouble. His grace is sufficient for us, and his strength is made perfect in our weakness. Therefore, I will rejoice even more in my infirmities. For when I am weak, he is strong. We can say those things from a place of experience, because we sought a place of safety. We sought some encouragement in our lives. We sought for inspiration in our lives. And the best place to get it is Jesus Christ. So I pray that today's songwriter's portrait by David Foster and Carol Bayer Sager is an encouragement to you to always continue to have that prayer in your heart and mind, that the Lord bless you and keep you. May his face and his face continue to shine upon you, and may you be grateful, and may he be merciful and kind to you everywhere you go, now, henceforth, and forever. No matter where you go, may he keep you in a place where you are safe in his arms, and be inspired by knowing that you are safe in him. May this song and this devotional be a blessing to you as well. Let's pray. Father God, we thank you for your grace. We thank you for your mercy. Lord, we thank you that you said you never leave us nor forsake us. So Lord, we thank you for the safe place that we find in you. We thank you for the encouraging place that we find in you. Lord, we thank you for the inspiration that you keep giving us every day through your grace and your mercy by reminding us you are with us. We are then inspired, and that we have hope to continue to be the best that we can be in all that we do, say, and think. And when we do falter, Lord, be with us. Lord, pick us up. Lord, help us to understand that we can get back up and keep on moving. So we thank you, and we give you glory and honor. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, this is the part of our devotional in which we give our birthday and anniversary shout outs. And on today, we want to wish a happy birthday to a set of twins, They were in high, I taught them in high school. Happy birthday to Josh Wood and his twin sister, who's now married. They're both married, but not to each other, but you get what I'm trying to say. Happy birthday to Josh Wood and his sister, Beth Smith. And also I want to wish a happy birthday to the president of, at when I was there, of the Furman University Gospel Ensemble. Happy birthday to Dr. Wendy Holmes. Wendy, Beth, and Josh, happy birthday to you all. May God bless you with many more birthdays, and enjoy your birthday on today. Now, to send in your birthday or anniversary shoutouts to be shouted out here on the Daily Pause, as well as any encouraging words that you want to share, whether it be something you saw in a tweet or a post, or something that you want to share through a video or for a post, just send them in to me, as well as any of your favorite songs or videos that you would like to see featured as a part of the Daily Pause devotional. Send them in to me by leaving them in the comment section below, or reach out to me on Facebook Messenger by email at glwilkins78@outlook.com. You can tweet me at gregwilkins78 or text me at 864-860-1522. Once again, I thank you for watching this devotional episode. I pray that this 10-week series of the songwriter's portrait will give you a new perspective and a new concept of how some songwriters and composers come about, how they convey what they go through and what they experience in life through their songs. Their search in safety and peace and understanding and protection and inspiration that David Foster and Carol Bayard Sager portrayed in a simple little song, in a simple little movie, went further than they thought it would, and it helped them out in their lives, and it helped out a lot of people in their lives as well. So I hope it's a blessing to you and an encouragement for you to always look for that safety in Jesus Christ. Continue to love each other, continue to be safe, and remember, every day there's always time to take a pause. And Lord willing, I will see you again on tomorrow. Enjoy today's feature song, The Prayer, written by David Foster and Carol Bayer Sager, and performed by Celine Dion and Andrea Bocelli. It comes from several different albums, but it's also came out as a single. The single was released in 1999, and it's just a blessing. I hope it's a blessing to you, and I hope you are encouraged and inspired to keep on praying that you be safe, that you always ask the Lord to guide you and lead you in everything you do, say, and think. Once again, I thank you for watching this edition of the Daily Pause Devotional. May God continue to keep you, increase you, and bless you in all that you do, say, and think on today. And take care, God bless, and I love you all. I thank you for watching, and Lord willing, I'll see you again on tomorrow. Today's feature song starts right now. Bye-bye.
With your grace to place Sento che ci salve.